In this vlog, we will try to see the implementation of method overloading in Python programming. So in general, when we deal with different programming languages like C, Java, there we can easily implement method overloading. But in Python, we need to do it in a different scenario. So follow this tutorial till the end and you will get an idea of how to implement a method overloading in Python. In our previous tutorial, we have seen operator overloading where we try to customize the operators like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division whenever we require to perform these computations onto a customized objects. Then we need to make use of the operator overloading. So we have discussed how we can perform operator overloading in our previous tutorial. So I am providing the link in the description section below for that particular tutorial. I suggest you to go through it before getting started with this particular tutorial. So if you are familiar with the topic, so now let's get started. So I would like to consider a class A, and here inside which I would like to define a method add. This will have the parameters like number 1, number 2 and number 3. I'm just considering in terms of n1, n2, n3, and I would be considering a variable result, and inside which I would like to save these values and now create an object for the class A and try to call the method add and provide these values, and now try to run this code and check the output here. And now you can just return result and now try to create an object for class A, try to print 1, 2, 3 here. And now try to run this code. So here we got the output to be 6 here. But what if we only have two parameters, that is n1 and n2. I am trying to particularly say that we exactly don't know how many parameters we will be having. So we need to handle if there is a single parameter, two parameters and also three parameters. So now let's try to customize this particular code and see. So if n1 is not none and n2 is not none, and similarly let's try to provide n3 also, result equal to n1 plus n2 plus n3. So I again suggest you to follow this perfect indentation to make sure you don't face any errors in your programming. Though you have specified the exact code, but if it is not following proper indentation, you might not get the output accordingly. So now let's try with elif. So in Python, else if is represented as elif, and try to provide n1 is not none, and now try to provide result equal to n1 plus n2. So don't forget a semicolon here. And the final thing is else, and here we don't require any statement to be verified. So we can just directly save n1 into the result. And now let's try to run this particular code and see again. So yes, we got 6 as output just like previously we did. And now let's try to remove 3 here and try to run this code. Oh, we got an error like n3 is missing. So what was missing here is like we need to initialize these things to none so that it will consider as none if we don't specify any parameter. So now let's try to rerun this particular code, and here you can see we got the output like 3. So we have provided only two parameters like 1 and 2, so it has gone through the second statement, that is elif, and provided the result. And now let's try to provide only a single parameter and try to run this code, and here you can see we got 1. So in this way we can implement method overloading in Python programming. Make sure you provide some default values to your variables. So here we need not even specify a space, so you can just remove them. So yes, if you are having any queries in this particular tutorial, do let me know in the comment section below. And also I suggest you to go through our Python beginners tutorial complete playlist. I am providing the link in the description section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Python.